About 2 dozen men, several vehicles, stun guns, and assault rifles. That's how the Brazilian army moves into the Mara Favela complex, one of the most dangerous in Rio. Captain Nelson Bianco is leading the patrol. They dismount in a place recently recaptured from drug gangs.
This area where we are now used to be a strong point from the gangs. It's called Monkey Island.
Monkey Island,
yeah.
Okay.
The favela appears peaceful. Children playing in the street, people going about their business. But the soldiers tell us they know the drug lords are still around and are watching them.
As you can see, there's preparations for the World Cup in this place as well. It feels pretty surreal to walk through a residential neighborhood with a flak jacket and a blast helmet on, but the army says that it is something that's necessary. They say that their patrols here have come under attack in the past. They also say that crime has gone down a lot since the patrol started, but of course, things still happen here.
Several people were killed here in gang violence even after the military moved in. That was in April of this year, when elite paratroopers entered the favela in armored vehicles. Today, the soldiers can at least walk the streets, always keeping a watchful eye.
When you go around these blocks, what do you look for?
We look for any kind of person that must be suspicious, so we can check them documents. We can check if they are carrying some drugs.
The army also mans checkpoints where they inspect cars coming into or leaving the area. But they can't be everywhere all the time. And people we try to talk to are clearly afraid of the drug gangs that still roam here. I prefer not to comment on the situation, this woman says, but it's all right. Things are quiet. Brazil set out to gain control over the favelas in the country ahead of the Olympics in 2016 and this year's World Cup. With kickoff fast approaching, the endeavor is still a work in progress. Fred Pleitgen, CNN, Rio de Janeiro.